everyone, it's Sarah. I've had a few requests for a YouTube video on how I make my bath truffles. Now, I have a few different recipes. I kind of change it depending on what I'm going for. With this video, I'm going to show you how to make a smooth bath truffle. It's a very simple recipe, very easy to do. It's the recipe that I used for my vanilla almond bath truffle. Nice and smooth, good solid bath truffle. What you're gonna need are, you're going to need baking soda, citric acid, a hard butter, I'm using cocoa butter. You are also going to need whatever fragrance you wanna use. For this one, I'm using Pink Berry Mimosa from Wholesale Supplies Plus. This is awesome, I love this one. You can also use, you have a few different options for your colorants. Color is optional, fragrance is optional. The only things that you really, really need are the baking soda, citric acid, and your hard butter. But for colorants, you can use mica, but if you use too much, you can color your entire tub. Only use as much as you need, like the smallest amount possible. You can also use cocoa powder like Hershey's powder that you use to bake with. Keep in mind though, that if you use that, it will turn your water brown, and some people find that very unappealing. I like to use La Bombe colorants. I also use a lot of micas. You just, like I said, you have to be careful with mica. But for this one, I'm using Girly Pink La Bombe colorant from Brambleberry. It is awesome. It will not stain your tub. It gets it the tint that you want pretty much every single time. Love La Bombe colorants. I'm also going to be embellishing this. However, you don't have to do that. That will be tomorrow. I will include it in this video to show you guys how I do it, but it's totally optional. You can leave them plain like I did with those. I kind of like my stuff to look like food. I don't know why. I want everything to look like, you know, cake and candy. So I'm probably going to drizzle it and stick all kinds of stuff on top because I never know when to stop. But my Pink Berry Mimosa will have a drizzle on it, and I'm doing a melt and pour raspberry on the top just because I think it gives a little pop of pretty. So, but that will be tomorrow. I'll show you guys how I do it. But today we're just gonna do the simple part, the bath truffle. Another thing you will need is whatever mold you are going to use. Silicone works great. I have these awesome little cube molds like this. I found these, they came in a pack of two. I think I got mine at TJ Maxx or Marshall's or brought one of those stores, but it was like, you know, two for $8 or something like that. You know, maybe do that. But I think what I'm going to do is maybe I'll do the tall one. I don't know. I might do the ice cube one, but I also have this little brownie cube thing. I just have to see if I can find it. I have like 500 million silicone molds all over, but okay. Anyway. So, get your mold, get your goodies, and let's get started. I apologize for the mess on here. I, at some point, melted the plastic on my scale, so that's great. You need 10 ounces of baking soda. Make sure there aren't any big clumps in it, but you're also going to be in there with your hands later, so you'll be able to break it up then. After you've measured that, you are going to have to measure out your citric acid, and you need 5 ounces of citric acid, and I'm gonna break up those clumpies later. Just kinda go in and break up any clumps. You can wear gloves if you, you know, get your nails did and all that, but I have 4 kids. I never get my nails done, so. All right, just kind of feel for any clumps and just pinch them. You're also gonna go through with a fork later. So, all right, now you've got your baking soda and your citric acid. All right, so the next thing you need is your cocoa butter or hard butter. I like cocoa butter because it's, you know, rock hard, but if you use something else, it's, honestly, I just recommend cocoa butter. You can use other stuff, and I make like combination, combine some butters. I love doing cocoa, mango, and shea. For some reason, that's like, you know, ah, awesome. But you need 6 ounces. And of course, I'm going to have to go get a knife and break off some of this. 6 ounces of cocoa butter. Almost there. Well, okay, that's I do have a little bit of OCD. Crafting OCD. Alright. 6 ounces of cocoa butter. Now, you can melt this with a double broiler, or you can do it in the microwave on 30-second bursts. Just keep a close eye on it. Don't let it get, you know, too hot, but either way works. So go ahead and melt down your cocoa butter, and while your cocoa butter is melting, measure out your fragrance oil. Your fragrance oil, you're going to need 0.35 ounces of fragrance oil. Continue to melt. You know, I can never find my temp gun when I need it. Ever. Can never find my temp gun. Okay, found it. Okay, so that's sitting at 136. Okay, sorry about that. I found my temp gun. This is sitting at 136. I'm gonna let it sit just for a little bit longer, just to get those last little chunks out. Now, the reason you want to take the temperature on this is I always add my fragrance to my oils. I combine all of my wet ingredients because I am super forgetful, and if I don't add all my wet ingredients together and then add them to my dry, I will forget to do it. So don't be like me. Don't forget stuff. But I don't want to add my fragrance to my cocoa butter when my cocoa butter, if my cocoa butter is too hot, because it could burn off the fragrance depending on the flash point of the fragrance oil. But the flash point on this is 200 degrees, so as long as it stays below 200, we're good. And yeah, pretty much, yeah, the rest of that will go really smooth. So I'm going to pour my fragrance in there. And just mix it up real quick. And then grab my girly pink. You can hear my baby talking to his siblings right now. And for this, I'm just going to put a couple drops in. Let's see. That was a lot more than a couple drops. It'll work. Okay, so that's all put together. Now the girly pink's not going to mix in until you mix it with your hands. So take off any rings or jewelry. You can put on gloves if you want. I don't really care. I don't have manicures or, you know, it doesn't bother me. So add the oil slowly to your dry ingredients, your baking soda and citric acid, and just kind of mix it up. Get it all out. And just mix. And as you mix, you'll see that the girly pink or the La Balm colorants, if you're using them, are starting to incorporate with the dry ingredients. And it'll start tinting the whole thing pretty soon. But it does take some elbow grease. See, there it goes. It's like pink applesauce. There's still some teeny little specks in there, but those don't bother me. I actually kind of like the way it looks. I think it looks like strawberry. All right. Now, while it's still nice and liquid, now is when you really want to kind of get your butt in gear. So, grab two clean spoons. Like I said, you gotta work while it's nice and hot, or else it'll set up. And this stuff does set up fast. So I'm using my little brownie bite mold. And you just want to go through and fill her up. Try not to make a mess, but I am a huge mess maker. I get splashes and dribbles all over the place. Cleaning my kitchen is always an ordeal. Okay, now all you do is set this aside and let it cool for at least 24 hours. Do not rush it. If it needs to sit for another day, let it sit for another day. I'm gonna kinda whack this a little bit. Kinda get the little air bubbles out. And you can see the air bubbles coming up to the top. And they'll kinda pop on their own, but I like to kinda help them along. So kinda whack it just a teeny little bit, but gently. Don't spill it. And like I said, let it sit for 24 hours to 48 hours. And when they are ready to come out super, super easy. They are rock hard. They pop right out. If you're having trouble or if you see the sides kind of pulling like gooey, they're not ready. So let them sit and we'll come back when they're ready to go and get these air bubbles out in the meantime.